are watching Channel Y. Channel Y, a South Asian Canadian channel.
एडवोकेट एच एस फुलका ने 1984 दे सिख विरोधी दंगिया ते कांग्रेस पार्टी ते गंभीर दोष लगांदे होए कहा है कि राजीव गांधी दे दफ्तर विचों ही दिल्ली च सिखां नूं मारन दीआं हदायतां दित्तीआं जा रहीआं सन। उन्होंने यह भी कहा कि प्रधानमंत्री ते दफ्तर दीआं हदायतां दे उत्ते फौज नूं बुलाया नहीं गया सी।
In 1984, when the Sikhs were being killed, the instructions were directly coming from Prime Minister's office, and the army was not called. It was on the instructions from the Prime Minister office, and it was being managed. You see, we have placed the evidence on the record of the commission, Nanavati Commission, as well as on Mishra Commission. And even Shanti Bhushan, he was the law minister during Morarji Desai government. Shanti Bhushan has given his own affidavit before the Nanavati Commission. He says on 1st November morning, if he went to Narasimha Rao, Narasimha Rao was the home minister at that time, and he asked Narasimha Rao to immediately call the army. The people are being killed. The innocent citizens are being killed. So Narasimha Rao agreed with him. Narasimha Rao tried to convince that person on the line to call the army. And after some time, when he realized that Narasimha Rao was not able to convince that man, Narasimha Rao put down the phone and sat quietly. Charan Singh Ji, he was the former prime minister, along with Devi Lal, Sharad Jadhav, and Ram Vilas Paswan. They go to the President of India, and they ask the President of India to immediately call the army. The President agrees that he will talk to the Home Minister and the PMO. That nobody came on the line. So President wanted to call the army. Home Minister wants to call the army. Who is the one who can veto them? It's the Prime Minister office. Then not only this, we have placed the evidence on the record that the Intelligence Bureau officers were even monitoring it. So even Mishra Commission has said that army was available. 5,000 army force was available in Delhi on the morning of 1st November 1984. And if that 5,000 army, which is available, could have been deployed, it could have saved 2,000 lives. So the 2,000 lives of the innocent citizens, 2,000 lives of the Sikhs, don't mean anything. This is directly the Prime Minister office who was managing it, controlling it. Unfortunately, due to the sheer power and of the government and their influence, they have suppressed all this evidence. But there is enough material to show it was directly Rajiv Gandhi's office which was giving the instruction to kill the Sikhs.
You are watching Channel Y, a South Asian Canadian channel.